Hey Aquarius, welcome to Queen Airbender Tarot. Today we are going to do your third week of March general love reading. Now, keep in mind this is a general reading, which means it cannot possibly apply to every single person that's watching. But if you like a personal reading, all of the information will be left in the description box below. In case you are new to the channel, welcome. Come on in. And in case you're returning, thank you for joining me again today. And I hope that you guys have been well. So Aquarius, and I almost said Capricorn. Some of you guys are definitely dealing with a Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus individual, or you can have those placements in your chart, especially your Venus. Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus individuals, when I was meditating over you guys' energy, the song that I got was The Closer I Get to You by Roberta Flack. And Donnie Hathaway. Now, Miss Roberta Flack happens to be a fellow Aquarian, and Donnie Hathaway was a Libra. So I feel like either you could be feeling this way, like those lyrics may really resonate for you on a heart level, or this person could be feeling like this about you. Now, what I got very strongly is that there's a type of connection that's going to get ready to evolve very quickly. I mean, feelings are going to come in very rapidly. It's just going to be a sweeping feeling of emotional attachment or wanting to be attached to someone, because the name of the song is The Closer I Get, right? The closer, it's like the more you guys spend time, the more you guys talk, the more you bond. It's like the feelings are going to get so intense very quickly. Now, if you're completely single, I do feel like somebody is coming in for you. For some of you all, this person could be coming in Libra season, and I know that's a little while away, but it could be the case if it's not a Libra person. Libra season is September, October time frame, so you could be meeting someone then. You also could have met someone in Libra season of last year, and it's like every single day you guys feel like it's just getting closer and closer, and you're already talking about marriage, long-term commitment, children, things like that. Now, again, if you're completely single, I feel like when you meet this new person, it's going to come in rapidly. I'm also hearing something about Cancer. So some of you guys could be meeting somebody in Cancer season, which is June, July time frame. Okay? So let's see what we get for Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus individuals. We're going to go through the deck until we get your major arcana, which happens to be the Star card. We'll get the card that comes before and the card that comes after, and then we'll get clarifiers for those cards. Currently, at the bottom of the deck, I'm trying to tell you, somebody want to offer you something immediately. Already, okay. Also, for some of you guys, you may be dating someone for less than a year, and it's like already finding out that you're pregnant or talks about having children. Okay, if you date someone, they already have a child or children, it's like you immediately bond and connect with this child, and this child immediately bonds and connects with you, and it's like you guys are instant family already. For some of you all, again, this won't apply to everyone. Some of you guys could be connecting or meeting someone new in Taurus season, April, May. Okay, getting that also. Yeah, somebody's coming towards you in Taurus season for a lot of you all. You got Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn here, and you have right in the corner Taurus energy. You got Taurus, Leo, your energy, Aquarius, and also Scorpio. Now, this same as Roberta Flack happens to be a fellow Aquarius. So, now, interesting enough, it just hit me with the world card that's talking about travel, distance, for movement. And the name of the song is The Closer I Get to You. Let me tell you something. Some of you guys could be dating someone or talking to someone at a distance. This person wants to close that gap. Okay, of distance between you two, and they're wanting to come visit you, or you guys will be talking about moving in together. There's plans for the future. Kings and queens, they only want long-term relationships, nothing short-term. And I did say some of you guys could be dealing with a water sign, specifically a Cancerian, or this person could be coming towards you in Cancer season, coming to visit you, or just saying like, you know what, let's get married, or talking about things in regards to marriage also. Again, if you are completely single, put in place what I was saying as far as the time frames in which we may meet someone new, okay? So we want the Star card for Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus individuals. The Star and the card that comes before and the card that comes after for Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus individuals. There you go. So, right in front of you, you have the Queen of Swords. And I did say Miss Roberta Flack happens to be an fellow Aquarian. Okay? So, you got Gemini, Leo, Aquarius here with the Queen of Swords. Right behind you, yet again, this doggone Page of Pentacles. I'm going to say again, some of you guys definitely will have a child with this person. This child could end up being an Earth sign, a Taurus, Virgo, or a Capricorn. If someone already has children, they can have a child that is an Earth sign. Again, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. And it's like automatically like just building a family. Wow, fool card. Taking a leap of faith into something new. Now, I did mention something with Cancer season in one of his hands. There's Cancer symbol, Cancer, Gemini. And one thing that I always point out that Cancer and Gemini have in common is June. Okay? Gemini season is May, June. Cancer season is June, July. So some of you all may meet somebody in Cancer season, specifically in June. Somebody could be coming to visit you also. Because it's like, I'm just going to take a leap of faith. I'm just going to go for it. And let's see where it goes. That's what I'm getting. You already had the King of Cups, and then you have the Queen of Swords here. And even though they're not the same element, that's a pair. Only a king can marry a queen, vice versa. Has to be someone of the same status, the same, you know, want the same thing. Kings and queens, they don't want short-lived. They want to build a legacy, and that's what you're getting ready to connect with, or you could be connected with already. Somebody definitely talking about, wow, Four of Wands marriage. Somebody's definitely talking about having a child. Somebody could be pregnant now, and you could be giving birth into a season. Definitely. And I'm, as I say, Taurus season starts in April, and you have the Four of Wands. Even though this is fire, but still, somebody may be giving birth to a child in April, or someone already has a April Taurus child, okay? But the Four of Wands is long-term commitment, union, marriage. And that's what I'm saying. That's what I'm getting. Like, I'm also getting someone, you guys purchasing a home together. It looks like they're celebrating in front of their home, you know? I'm getting that also. It's part of the deck. Three of Pentacles, working, building, establishing something together. Absolutely. Entering contracts, marriage, parenthood. I'm getting a lot of good stuff for you guys. But it's like, I am getting a distance. Now, some of you guys, it could be a physical distance. Like, you guys live in different cities, different states. And then for others, the distance could literally be that you haven't met this person yet. They're coming in. They are coming in. The universe is already, they're already transpiring behind the scenes for this to happen. This is on the way to you. Bottom of the deck, on the way to you. Now, I'm going to say again, I keep getting something with Taurus, okay? If you notice right here, the death card is Scorpio, but if you notice, this looks like the Hierophant. Hierophant is Taurus. Scorpio season, you know, well, not Scorpio season, but Scorpio is a death and rebirth transformation with the death card. I feel like what's transpiring, what's getting ready to change is the distance. Again, that horse is getting ready to go on a journey. If there's a distance between you and someone physically, that's ending. Death is ending. Now, if you have not met anyone, there's nobody in your life right now, I definitely feel like that's ending. That's transforming. That's transmuting. It's upright. That's major arcana, so that's definite. That's changing for you. And I also get death being an ending. That's the end of that. That's the end of you being single. That's shifting for a lot of you guys. Let's get a clarifier for the Queen of Swords. Clarifying for the Queen of Swords. For Aquarius, Sun, Rising, Venus, individuals. Woo, okay. This one flipped out sideways, and you had two more. Didn't I say the Hierophant? When we seen the death card, you got it in reverse. Some of you guys are going to meet somebody in Taurus season. Sideways, you have the Tower. Scorpio, you have the death, Scorpio. Scorpio and also Aries. Now, sideways, you have that clarifying the Queen of Swords. What I'm getting with this is, like, if some of you all are in a situation where it seems like, well, we're not going to be able to be together because of the distance, and I can't move there because of my job, or you can't move here because of your job, or it just, we just don't see it happening. That's not an end all. Because upright, that's yes. That's the Tower's coming down. Like, it's something that's being chaotically destroyed. But in reverse, it's like, okay, let's put the brakes on it, let's try to stop this from ending. And sideways is like, somebody could be of the mind like, you know what, let's cut this off. She has a sword up, I'm gonna cut this off. And then there's another person like, no, let's fight for it because we can make it work. So I definitely am getting that. If you're dealing with a situation where, you know, there's a distance between you and this person. And then I'm going to say again, for those of you who are completely single and there's nobody in the picture, you could be thinking like, you know, my life is full of tower moments. I'm never, ever going to find my person. The universe is like, that's a mental thing, because Swords is mental, right? It's like, that's just a thought. That's not true. We're coming in with an offer. We're coming in with an offer, and this offer is going to be stable at that. Bottom of the deck, Nine of Pentacles, single woman, single man. I don't feel like a lot of you guys will be single much longer. For some of you guys, you definitely will be in a relationship by Taurus season for sure. So you got Taurus, Gemini, and Cancer. And all those time frames are boom, boom, boom. We also had Libra earlier. But Taurus, Gemini, Cancer, all of those are back to back. Boom, boom, boom. And then after that, you got Libra, which is September, October. And you did just have the Nine of Pentacles in reverse. So I feel like a lot of you all is not going to be that long. It's not going to be September until you meet somebody. It's going to be within the next couple of months for a lot of you all. Okay. Let's get a clarifier for the Page of Pentacles for Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, individuals. Clarifier for the Page of Pentacles, okay? Yeah, one flip out and it landed right on top of the star card, your major arcana. You got the Seven of Wands in reverse. I actually like this. Seven of Wands upright is guardedness, defensiveness, blockages. He's trying to block those wands from coming at him in reverse. Whatever blockages that you have to love coming in, it's being dissipated. That's going to the wayside. There's no more blockages when it comes to your love life. And also feel like that's confirmation, because remember I was saying Libra season. Libra season is September, October. We are in the third month of this year. You get the Seven of Wands. 7 plus 3 is 10. 10 could still be Libra season. In reverse, they're saying, like, you're not going to have to wait to the end of the year. Your person's going to come in much sooner. Some type of offer of love and a connection is going to come in much sooner. For some of you guys, it will be a Taurus person or in Taurus season. Gemini and also Cancer season. And again, if there was blockages, okay, this upright, this is blockages. If there were blockages keeping you and your person from connecting physically, because Pentacles is the physical, it's coming to an end. It's coming to an end. Okay? So Aquarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus individuals, as always, I'm going to ask that you continue to like, share, subscribe, click the notification button, and until next time, take care and be well. Bye.